Hey everyone, Sherry here. So this is going to be a twin flame reading for March the 2nd until the 9th. So I've hit a couple of milestones with the channel. I hit over 1,000 subscribers, but also over 1 million watch minutes. Oh my God. So I don't know if you guys know my story, but I started the channel just to share my videos in my group, no fucks given. So I had no intention of having, my own tarot channel and, or, it being geared towards twin flames directly. But that's just where my journey has taken me, and I'm grateful for it. And it's opened up a whole new world for me, something I never expected, and I'm getting so much enjoyment and gratitude from it. So thank you so much for all of your support, your comments, your likes, your shares. Namaste. I love you guys. Thank you. Okay, so to show my appreciation, I'm gonna do an extended twin flame reading. So it's going to be a twin flame plus a divine partnership combined. So I'm going to be using the Archangel Power tarot cards for the main energy, but I'm also going to be pulling three cards each for each position using my own cards here. So let me just shuffle these. And then I'm going to be using John Holland Psychic Tarot for the Union Energy. I'll be pulling five cards, and I will pull one card each for clarifiers using the Osho Tarot. So this is a John Holland Psychic Tarot, and this is the Osho. Then I'm going to be pulling two cards for the message from the universe. So it's going to be a lengthy video, so get comfy. Okay, Spirit, what messages do you have for the twin flames? Now, I know there's been a spike in communication recently. The communication, although some of it is really good, others have communicated and it's caused some fear. It's almost causing the feminine to run, to become the runner. So I'm asking the feminines to hold your heart center, hold your balance, and stay calm. This is what you wanted. And I'm seeing a spike in an awakening of the masculine as well. So what messages do you have for us, Spirit? For March the 2nd until the 9th. Okay, so I'm going to put these cards down. They're all shuffled. And let me get these out of the way for a minute. All right, so this is the masculine's present, or sorry, how he views a relationship. Seven of Michael. There is a better course of action available to you. Working alone may not be the best answer. Review all the details. So, Seven of Swords, this is that deception and envy, having doubt and fear, like you don't have all the answers. Something is holding you back, or something is causing you to hide and not face those fears. Someone pull three cards. First card, Ten of Pentacles. So this is that happy ending. That's that sense of finally arriving, or not arriving, but being at that place of rest, peacefulness. It's working your entire life to build up this wealth, but the importance is not placed on the wealth. It's actually placed on the fact that you're surrounded by family. There's a sense of security. Yeah, it's time to enjoy your family. So, one more card, please. All right, Tower. So this is something that happens suddenly, unexpected. It comes out of the blue. It shakes your world. It rocks your foundation. It changes everything. This talks about holding on to this material life, the material possessions, your stories, that character that you built up for yourself, and realizing that it's all an illusion. It's all made up in your head. You are attached to this, but it's not real. What's real is love and family, and being in that secure place, that, you know, that sense of home. So it's almost like, you know, the masculine is starting to realize that materialistic, ego-driven thought forms are in reality an illusion. It's not real. It's a construct. What is real is family and love. Okay, one more card. The Eight of Wands. This is could mean communication, but it could also represent a forward-directed energy towards a goal. It could mean that finally you're starting to see the fruits of your labor, seeing things from a higher perspective, reaching for the stars. So it's almost like there's an aha moment and the tower comes down and it reveals this truth, this happy ending. And it seems to me like he wants to communicate that to his divine feminine, that he has had this major shift in consciousness, and he's ready to shed his old identity. If that makes sense. Okay. So now I'm going to pull her card for love and relationship. Ace of Pentacles. It's your lucky day. New resources of money, time, or support. A change in job or promotion. But I like to see this as a seed is planted for the material world. It's a material manifestation. It's a beginning. It is prosperity begins. It's laying that foundation and working towards a goal in the future. So it's a start in the 3D world. So you see your love and relationship with the masculine as this new beginning in the 3D world. It's abundance, prosperity. Okay, three cards. Nice, yeah. Oh my God. An ace reduces to a one, and then we got our 11-11 calling card. Awesome. So I decided that for my deck, the Four of Wands, I have a fireplace with this roaring fire, and it represents, you know, that completion stage, but a brand new beginning, its accomplishment, its, you know, marriage. So I decided that I'm going to keep that Four of Wands as its original meaning, you know, of arrival, accomplishment, or what have you. And this card is my going to be the 11-11 calling card only. All right, so you see this relationship for what it really is, the 11-11 connection, the evolution in consciousness. You know what it is. There's no doubt in your mind. But he, on the other hand, is coming into that knowing. You know, the tower is that sudden realization, you know, of what really matters. So two more cards, please, Spirit. Nice, the Two of Wands. So you have a door open. This is seeing the bigger picture. When you look out, you see the universe and how you're connected to it. Seeing all the possibilities. So your mind is expansive right now. One more card, please. All right. Yeah, girls. Awesome. So this is a Queen of Cups. This is emotional abundance, fulfillment. It's being in touch with love and expressing it and being warm and generous, caring, intuitive. You know, being in touch with your psychic ability. Sorry. So here we got the Queen of Cups in tune with her consciousness. Then we have the Two of Wands, which is like two wands, one, one, right? And then we got this 11-11 and an ace. Wow. That is beautiful. You are warm, loving, open, beautiful souls. So I couldn't pick a better group of cards than this. If you are standing here with your arm, your hand open, offering this new beginning in the 3D world, and you know it's the 11-11 connection. There's no doubt in your mind. And you're ready to give your love to your masculine. The Queen of Cups talks about being mysterious and drawing men to the depths of their subconscious. So you are using your beauty, your light, to draw your masculine towards you. Beautiful. Okay, so for what he's resisting, the Ten of Wands. Ask your angels for helpful people to lighten your load, working too many hours, trying too hard to please others. So the Ten of Wands is that point where you just can't go on anymore. But it's a completion, right? Ten reduces to one. You're finally done with all of the burden, and you're ready to put that down and rest. But this is in his resisting position, so this means he's resisting putting an end to this feeling. Nice. This is a lover's card. So this is another twin flame calling card. So this is my own deck. So I get to choose what the cards mean. My intention when I made this card is union, twin flame union only. This is the twin flame connection. It is, you know, that yes, this is a connection for twins. Okay, so when I get a scratchy throat like this, it generally means that there's something going on with conversation. Communication has to happen, and he got that in his present position, how he views a relationship. So I'm starting to get a scratchy throat when we're talking about this union. Okay, next card is the Queen of Wands. So this is his object of desire. It is a woman who's charismatic, who shines brightly. You know, she's the sun, the queen of the, you know, passion and desire, sexuality. She's the center of attention. Men desire her and women want to be like her. So it's almost like there's this burst of fire going on right now. Ten of Wands, that's fire. So like there's this blaze that's lit. And the lover's card is two twins coming together, you know, in union. And then we got the Queen of Wands, and she is the Queen of Fire. So this is the Queen of Pentacles. So this is the queen in the 3D world. You know, someone you can touch, kiss, hug, hold. So she is the object of his desire, and he wants to touch her, hold her in the 3D world. But he's resisting that, and it's causing him to feel exhausted, overburdened. He recognizes that this love is special. It's different from anything that he's ever experienced. Okay, so for what she's resisting, Ace of Michael, another ace. Wow, girls, this is crazy. So a wonderful new idea. Don't allow bumps in the road to hinder your progress. Clear up communication problems with others. So the Ace of Swords, this is clear thought, communication. It's having an idea and going forward with it. It's success, triumph, victory. It is a feeling of being empowered and strong, and truth. Above all, it's speaking your truth. Nice. Okay, this is a divine feminine. The twin flame. Again, I made this card specific to represent the divine feminine. Twin flame. So she understands the true nature of this twin flame journey. She has clarity. She's standing here with her sword of truth. But again, it's in a resisting position. Nice. The Ace of Pentacles, again. That's 11 here. So that's this card. So you are standing here in your divine form, and you're holding this key in your hand, an offering in the 3D world, this brand new beginning, this new life. That seed is planted. Now, the divine feminine, that would be, the Empress in the Rider-Waite deck. So the Empress is someone who manifests things into reality. The manifestation is just on the horizon. Something is about to give birth. She's a very loving, nurturing, warm, mothering type. She creates life. She births life. She births creation. So there's almost a sense that she is impregnated with this seed, this new beginning. And so it's in her resisting position. One more card, and I answer that. So this is the Moon card, Major Arcana. It is not seeing your way clearly. It is facing your shadow aspect. It is using your subconscious, your intuition to guide you. So I'm not sure why this would be in a resisting position, because these are beautiful cards. You know, we got these two aces with the divine feminine in the middle. So it's almost like, you know, there is a cloud surrounding her. And it's creating confusion, maybe. Well, we'll have to see what the rest of the cards say, but the Ace of Michaels is cutting through barriers, cutting to the truth of the matter. So it seems to me like there's this illusion or this unknown, and she needs to cut away to the truth, and she's not doing that. It has to do with this seed, this new beginning. Oh my gosh. Okay, I'm going to have to move some cards over here. Beautiful card so far. Okay, so this is the masculine's message from his higher self. Justice. Fight for justice and equality, ruling made in your favor. Don't give up. So the justice card is about karma. What you reap, you sow. It's a balance. It is looking at your life with clarity, and reevaluating it and seeing where adjustments need to be made in order to live a balanced life. But in terms of karma, this talks about karma coming back to you in a good way. Judgment has been made in your favor. So don't give up. Fight for justice. Fight for truth. There's that repeated theme again of truth. Okay, so three cards, two of cups, five of wands, and the sun card. So the two of cups, that's spiritual union, that's coming together, seeing your mirror. Wow, it's, you know, he's getting a lot of union cards right now. So, yeah, that's sharing love, feeling love, being open to love. Then we got the Five of Wands, which is obstacles and challenges. This is being in conflict with somebody or feeling like you're being challenged, like you have competition around you. But feeling like you need to overcome an obstacle in order to move forward. So then we got the Sun card. This is the best card in the major arcana. So this is everything good. It's peace, harmony, bliss, abundance, prosperity. It is a brand new beginning in life. It's having an optimistic future. It's feeling innocent and, you know, playful and excited. In the Rider-Waite deck, it depicts a child who's naked riding this white horse of purity. So it's a return to innocence. So it seems to me like his higher self is telling him that this is true love, that he wants a union. And, you know, the obstacles that he needs to overcome is small. It's, you know, minor. It's petty. It's, you know, a small step over. And ultimately, it will bring him that ultimate happiness. A connection with your child, your innocence, your purity. And so that coupled with the Justice card is like he is getting arriving at that point where he's seeing things aren't as challenging as he thought it was, and he's starting to see the light. The Sun card is a masculine energy. It is, the Sun is masculine while the Moon is feminine. So that's interesting. Okay, so what is the message from the feminine's higher self? Nice! Oh my God! Oh my God, Ace of Cups. Cup runneth over, it's abundance of love. It's being that open vessel to receive love. So a positive new emotional experience, fulfillment, fulfilling romantic relationships, deep and lasting spiritual insights. Wow. Bam, three aces. That's fucking amazing. I'm sorry for swearing, but unsub me if you want to. I don't care. This is amazing. She got the Ace of Pentacles there too. So she got four aces. Okay, so three cards. Justice, 11. Oh my God. So this is karma coming back. So he got this as a main energy for his message from his higher self. And the one, actually, or the Sun card reduces to one. It's 19. So the justice, karma coming back. Finally something working out in your favor after, putting so much effort and work into it. Yeah, that's good. Okay, so wow, another one. This is a Ten of Wands, exhaustion. It's the exact same card as this one. A lot of synchronicities. And the Seven of Pentacles. So this talks about waiting, but having patience, putting a great deal of work into something in the 3D world, and waiting for that harvest to come, waiting for that payoff. But this card says that it's almost there. Stay grounded. Use self-control, and ultimately, have patience. So the four cards together, we got this brand new beginning of love, this cup of love offered to you from the universe. And you will have justice. It's causing you to stay up at night and feel, not stay up at night, but feel exhaustion. Like you don't want to go on anymore. I'm tired. I want to put the burden down. You know what I mean? This is a woman who is physically, mentally, and emotionally exhausted. She's taken on too much. She feels like she has to do it all by herself. She's laying in bed, and hasn't slept, and that alarm clock is going to ring soon. And it's because she's been waiting. She doesn't want to wait anymore. But karma is saying that it's not going to be much longer, that opportunity or something is going to be knocking at your door. Okay, so for his recent past position, Nine of Michael, your worry is unnecessary. Focus your thoughts on the outcome you desire. Release feelings of regret, guilt, or worry to your angel. So Nine of Michael, he's been consumed by thought. So this is a dark night of the soul. This is being consumed by fear. And guilt. You feel like you did something wrong. Sorry, one moment. I just need to adjust my leg here. Okay, so yeah, it's a feeling of you did something wrong in the past because this is coming up in the past position, and you need to face that fear. It's a feeling of finally being ready to move on. Out of the mind, leave the past behind you. So, Hangman talks about surrendering, letting go, seeing things from a different perspective. It is illumination, enlightenment. It is being connected to your soul on a spiritual level. So, it's a detachment, it is going within. It is a time of rejuvenation, healing. Clarity, using your inner seeing, knowing, hearing to guide you out of this darkness. So it's like he had this blindfold on. He couldn't see his way clearly. He had created a mental prison for himself in the past. Nice. Ten of Cups, another one. So, Ten of Cups is that emotional fulfillment, bliss. It is that happy ending, happily ever after. In the Rider Waite deck, it depicts a couple with some children running around and playing in the yard, and there's this huge rainbow of cups, overarching this house that they created. But the house is represents that. That safety, that emotional permanency. Nice. The King of Wands. This is him stepping into his power. He is the center of the sun. It's having a vision, an idea, and going forward with that vision. So I'm going to read that to you. I'm not going to pause the video because I want this to be like a steady shot, uncut. So this is Tarot Illuminati. I seem to be getting this King of Wands a lot for the masculine recently. So I really feel that he's stepping into his power. King of Wands, the center of the sun. The strongest desires burn with the most heat. The strongest of wills burn brightest, and heat always rises. I am the height of my very self, the pinnacle of everything that is possible, the achievement of all things. I am everything that I ever wanted to be and more. And I am a master of all. The four worlds are at my fingertips. All skills are in my knowledge. I have seen the world and I have heard all its songs, met all its people, loved fiercely and deeply, adventured beyond the limits of my perception. There is nothing I cannot do, nothing I do not want to do. I live on it. I thrive on it. I am God incarnate, seated upon a sunlit throne. The center of the universe, I burn as brightly as a midday sun. Once you have beheld me, you will never forget me. So yeah, there's a sense that he changed his perspective. He released himself from a mental prison and envisioned this happy ending, this bliss, this peace, this ultimate harmony, and stepped into his power. His leadership, his, you know, having that idea, that goal, and going forward with that goal, you know, his object of desire. So he got the Queen of Wands in his resisting position, along with the Queen of Pentacles. All right. So the feminine's recent past position. No way! Oh my God! Wow! Another ace. You got all four aces. 11-11. Wow! That is freaking amazing. A gift of passion, opportunity, and inspiration. The chance to do something amazing. A sense of wonder. So to me, the ace of Wands is that thrust forward. It is the go light. It's go time. It is a brand new start of life. It is going after your dream. Wow, guys. Okay, so transformation, metamorphosis, death card. The Queen of Swords. So this is communication. It's cutting to the truth. It is detaching yourself emotionally from a situation. It is using mental control over emotions. And the death card is cutting away old identity. Putting an end to something so something new can come in. So it seems to me like you've transformed in the past. You grew your wings. You burst out of this cocoon. As a result of this passion, this ignition switch, High Priestess. So this is the divine feminine in her spiritual form. She is connected to source. She goes within, uses her intuition, her psychic ability, her connection to the divine. She, in the recent past, there was this ignition, this light, this beginning, a realization, which caused a transformation, and you ultimately were reborn into this truth, which has to do with your awakening, your spiritual connection to Source. Okay, so for the Divine Masculine's present position, Gabriel. Eight of Wands, again, communication. I knew this reading had to do with communication. A great deal of activity, sudden and immediate results, important communication. So he wants to communicate something right now. Let's pull. Two of Pentacles. So this is finding balance. Feeling like the ground is unstable, that there's chaos, things are shifting, it's change in the 3D world. It is making a decision. Page of Pentacles. So this is somebody who is putting a lot of thought and effort into planning something for the future. And it has to do with something in the 3D. So it's a movement forward in terms of your mind. It's seeing the possibilities and working towards that. The Hermit card. So this is about detaching from the material world. It's going off on your own on a spiritual quest for knowledge, inner wisdom. It's using your light within to shine in order to guide others out of the darkness. So what I'm getting here, it's almost like he's presently working on something. And he's retreated in order to gain his balance and focus his mind and will on a directed goal, shooting for the stars. But it requires him to retreat, to get in touch with his inner self. And make a decision. It's a change. Okay, so the feminine's present position, three of Ariel. Do what you love, time of great personal growth in your career or artistic endeavors, working with others in a cooperative manner. So this is, you know, building that foundation, laying that solid groundwork in the 3D world. It's being recognized for all of the hard work that you've put in. It's being rewarded. It's success, triumph, victory. Having the light shining on you. It also talks about putting everything you got into a project. Every ounce of your being into that project. The Hierophant, which is the High Priest. The Wheel of Fortune. And nice, the Four of Wands. So this is what I was talking about at the beginning of the reading, that I'm now keeping this card to mean its intended energy, not the 11-11 connection. Okay, but that's awesome that you got this in your present position. So this tells me that you've laid the groundwork and you're being recognized for those accomplishments, that all that work that you've done in the past. And it has to do with this spiritual enlightenment, this journey, this being this leader. The High Priest is the one who is connecting the spiritual world to the 3D world. He's kind of like the go-between. He has divine knowledge and shares it with others. So This is a present position. So you are being illuminated and recognized as a leader. And the Wheel of Fortune, this is Justin Timberlake, that song, What Goes Around Comes Around. So this talks about karma coming back to you. It's the wind of change. It means that there's a significant change taking place within you as well as your outer world. So this talks about karma coming back to you in a good way, that there's a cycle of completion nearing the end. And it has to do with this Four of Wands, that love, that final place of serenity. This could mean marriage, engagement, buying a new home, new property, travel. But it's about harvest. It's having that abundance. You know, it's you and your twin relaxing and enjoying life in front of this fire. So yeah, you're being recognized as laying that foundation regarding an awakening, and something that you've been wanting for a long time is going to come towards you. And it's harvest, it's abundance, it's all good feels. Okay, so for the masculine's future position, Five of Gabriel. A challenge you can resolve. Withdraw from the drama of others. Have patience with yourself and those around you. So the Five of Wands, that is this card here. He got it as a message from his higher self, and now he's getting it as a future outcome. So there's an obstacle that he will overcome in the future by the sound of it. Let's see here. Nice. The World card, completion. The major completion of a cycle. It is the end of the fool's journey. It's, again, triumph, victory, harvest, reward. It is a brand new beginning. It's a completion and a brand new beginning, right from scratch. It's before the fool's journey. So the fool's journey is the first card in the major arcana. This is the final card. This is a long cycle of change, you know, up to 20 years. So you faced all your fears, you put your past behind you, you've healed your heart, you've set your goals in motion, you know, you've awakened. It's that final piece of the puzzle is being put in place. Ten of Swords reduces to one. This is the end. It's a completion of feeling like you have been stabbed in the back. It's a progression from this card here, the Nine of Swords. So it's almost, you know, his cards seem to be pointing towards this, you know, this realization, this aha, this burst into consciousness from the dark to the light. It's a completion. Both of these cards represent completion. So this is, you know, being left for dead. In the Rider Waite deck, it depicts a man laying on the ground, and he's got 10 swords in his back, and he's done. He's it's over. You know what I mean? Like, there's nowhere to go but up. And like, these are almost like opposite, exact opposite energies. This is like that dark night of the soul, and you're down for the count. That's it. And then we got this world card, and that's that completion. It's that final victory. Death and rebirth. From as a result of an obstacle that he had to overcome. Nice. The Knight of Pentacles. So he got this Two of Pentacles in his present position, along with the Page of Pentacles and the Hermit card. So it's, you know, having that idea, that goal, and moving forward with it. And it has to do with, you know, his spiritual enlightenment and finding balance between his spirituality and his physical world. So it's putting an idea into motion and it's planning ahead for it. And here the Knight of Pentacles is this final arrival. This is the absolute best knight to get because it is a very assured, measured, calculated, very long journey that's finally coming to completion. You can see here he's on a tightrope, and he's taking one step at a time. Every step is measured. And like, it is the longest period of wait, which is crazy because it kind of mirrors this world card. You know, there's this final completion, and wow, the Knight of Pentacles will finally arrive at his destination. And it's a result of going through this dark night of the soul. It's this grand awakening. This is absolutely beautiful. So he's stepping over that obstacle and walking the tightrope in order to get to this final completion stage. So the final outcome for the feminine, Six of Ariel. Material needs get fulfilled in magical and unexpected ways. Acts of kindness, giving and receiving with a grateful heart. So this talks about being open to receiving and giving. It's, you know, priming the pump of gratitude. It is being open. It talks about material harvest, feeling of abundance, and continuing to work towards your goal. But it has to do with the 3D world. The Chariot, going after your goal, but using your will and self-control in order to do it. You've taken control of the reins and you're directing your life towards that ultimate goal. So it's a very fiery energy. It's, it has to do with what you desire, your passions, your, it's what sparks that fire within you. That Ace of Wands, you know, that fire. And this is, it's almost like the fuel for the fire to move you forward. But it there's a sense of being uneasy. You know, the energy is a little shaky, nervous kind of energy to it. No way. Oh my God. The King of Pentacles. That's this card up here. It is like the Queen's King. Queen of Pentacles, King of Pentacles. So this is in his resisting position. He's resisting this union. The object of his desire, he wants to manifest this queen into his reality. And here, as your outcome, we got this chariot coming forward, and it's carrying the King of Pentacles, the 3D King. So this could also represent abundance, harvest. He represents that time where you've worked a lot to build this foundation. So I like to think of this card as being this guy retired. So he's a little bit, you know, older, 20 years older. But this card, both of these cards actually talk about working your entire life and building this wealth and abundance for yourself, feeling safe and secure. But you don't place your values on the material world. You place it on the feeling of love and having family around you. He's very a fun energy to be around. He's jovial. He he shares his wealth. So that's what this card talks about, the Six of Pentacles, is about being open to receive and give. Nice! The Magician, the Master Manifester. This is a card of manifesting your dreams into reality. It is number one, the Magician. So this is the Tesla. He draws energy from the ethereal through the source and uses that energy to harness his potential, to create his reality in the 3D world. So he is a connection between source and material things that you can touch, taste, and feel. So in your future, Divine Feminine, there will be an arrival of this materialized, manifested King of Pentacles. Or he will be open in some way in the material world, whether it's, you know, communication or just, something will occur in your future regarding a contact in the 3D world with the masculine. Okay, so what is message for the masculines from the universe? Three of Gabriel. Prosperity arising from wise planning. Time to take the next step. Optimistic plans that turn out as expected. Nice. Three of Wands. Again, this is putting a lot of work into something and waiting for that return. And Spirit is saying that the wait is almost over. Nice. Good news coming your way. It's that forward-directed energy, very similar to the Chariot. But it isn't an unstable energy like the Chariot. This is like a directed arrow. It is seeing your goal, your vision, and moving forward with it. And it's a quick energy. It happens very suddenly, a thrust forward. It's like this gasoline was poured on a fire and it whoosh, like that, an explosion. So it's almost like Spirit is saying that the reward is coming soon, and as a result of it, it will cause this thrust forward. Nice. Oh my God. Page of Wands. This is the actual fuel card. Let me read that to you, okay? I've been getting that card in the reading quite a bit. So the Page of Wands. The fuel of the fire. Before fire is even a spark, when it is merely an idea, an impulse towards light and heat, there must be the fuel. No creative act occurs without inspiration, without a foundation, without grounding in reality of action. I am the grounding in which creative impulses are seated, the waiting womb into which the first fiery burst of inspiration is planted and rooted, the setting of desire when an impulse finds action and result. It is the girding of my loins that I bring forth my fire. Yet with my birthing into actuality of the first spark of, or sorry, into actuality of the first spark of inspiration, sorry, I'm getting this mixed up, I also become the limitation of creativity, the boundaries within which desire and passion function. I am the container of fire, the lamp, the torch, the hearth. I am the vessel of creativity, of creative thought and passionate impulse. The finished masterpiece, the thrust of desire, the result of inspiration. So, yeah, there's this blaze. you know, this thing that he's been suppressing, this thing that he's been resisting, suddenly there's this, you know, thrust forward. These are all wands. It's all fire. And it's going for your, towards your goal. Pages are messengers, so it could be about communication. Six of Pentacles, or sorry, Five of Pentacles. This talks about feeling left out in the cold. It's, it could be a self-imposed restriction or self-sabotaging yourself, shooting yourself in the foot. You know, it could be financial loss, but there's a sense that there will be an end to that feeling of being left out. Okay, so message for the feminine, page of Ariel. An excellent opportunity will be offered to you. Scholarships or pursuits of education, time to get to work. So he got this in his present position. And you're getting it as a message from the universe. So you've been putting a lot of work into something to make it materialize in the 3D world. So it is search for knowledge. Five of Swords. This is conflict and defeat. It is engaging in, you know, arguments with other people. It is winning at all cost. It is pointing the finger at someone. Divine masculine. Wow. So this is the twin, divine twin flame in his masculine form. This is a message from the universe. One more card here. Nice! The Ace of Cups. So, this is so confusing. It's, you know, it's almost like this card doesn't have its negative connotation to it. It's a card that is simply pointing at the divine masculine. That what you worked for in the past, the thing that has been causing you to feel conflicted, will materialize as a divine masculine. It's, you know, your, that thing that you've been working for in the 3D, the page. Yeah, that's beautiful. So here we have the Divine Feminine with the Ace of Swords standing here with the Sword of Truth, with her hand open, an invitation of, you know, impregnated with the seed of knowing. But there's that sense of illusion, unconsciousness, like, you know, something is obstructing her vision. Something's preventing her from speaking her truth, but she stands here with an offer. And then as your message from the universe, it's like the universe is saying, you know, don't worry. You know, this is the truth. There's this abundance of love. The cup is overflowing. You're a vessel for love. And it has to do with your connection with the divine masculine. Energy that is surrounding the masculine, the King of Gabriel, again, the King of Wands, you got that where is it Oh, here it is. He got it in his recent past, so I read it to you guys. So it is, it says, keep your eyes on the big picture. Leave the details to others. Experience that leads to success, genuine concern for others. So there's, yeah, I'm going to pull some cards for that. Six of Cups, reunion, somebody coming back from your past, somebody that makes you feel loved, innocent, and pure. So this is a surrounding energy, so nice. The Strength card, using kindness, compassion when dealing with the situation is stepping into your power. And the Knight of Swords, rebel without a cause, it's mental control, it's new ideas, going forward with an idea, and it's open, honest communication. So his surroundings makes him feel like the King of Wands, like he is the center of the sun. And it makes him feel emotionally satisfied, safe. When he thinks about this connection, his heart chakra opens, and he has fond memories of this connection. And he's trying to find his strength and courage in order to communicate his truth. Okay, so the surrounding energy for the feminine, Five of Michael. So again, this is that same energy here. It's almost like, you know, you're pointing the finger at the masculine saying, you know what, you did something wrong here. You need to, you know, address this. You know, and he's bringing that Seven of Swords as well as how he views the relationship. Like, he feels like, you know, the finger is being pointed at him. There's a sense of dishonor. Okay, so the Page of Swords, this is communication, a messenger. It is speaking your truth. The Nine of Wands, the Wounded Warrior, and the King of Swords, the King of Air. It is, could represent an air sign. But the first card is communication. There's this empty victory here, conflict, defeat, walking away from something. And it has to do with communicating your truth, and it's, you know, it's causing the sense of being wounded, having scars from the battle. And then this King of Swords is cutting away that emotional baggage and using strong mental control. He is the ultimate he's ultimate clarity. So this, your surrounding energy is this Five of Swords. It's pointing a finger, and it has to do with communication, and it's causing a wounded heart, like you to feel wounded. Okay, so for what the masculine fears, the Page of Cups, gentle, loving, dreamy, open-hearted, a new emotional situation, messages regarding relationship or social invitation, great intuitive insights. So yeah, this is, he's afraid of expressing his love. It's a message of love, it's a beginning of love. Broken heart, the Three of Swords, he's scared of having his heart broken. King of Cups, being in tune with your emotions and expressing your emotions. You know, it's, the King has pure love. It's very deep. and the star card, wish granted. So he's afraid of getting in touch with his true emotions and expressing those emotions because he's afraid of having his heart broken. But the star card is wish granted, but it also talks about coming out of a period of a very difficult period, and now you're healing yourself. So have patience. Wow, look at all that fire. Crazy. All right, so final card for the feminine. 10 of Pentacles. Oh my God, so this is what you fear. So that he got this card in his present position. So 10 of Pentacles. There is a so very much to be grateful for. Financial success and promise of retirement. A rich and rewarding family life. 4 of Cups. Longing. Feeling like things aren't moving fast enough. Feeling detached. So longing. Wanting. Waiting. 6 of Pentacles again. You got that as an outcome. So it's being open to sharing. And then the 8 of Pentacles. This is working towards something. Putting, you know, all of your effort into shaping your surroundings. Producing abundance. So you fear that this ultimate ending, this 10 of Pentacles, this retirement, this final resting place won't happen. You feel like it's not happening fast enough. And so Spirit is saying that you've been putting a lot of work into this relationship and that abundance is coming, harvest is coming. Hang in there, have patience. All right, so now I'm going to pull... I'm just going to stop the video because I know that I'm going to run out of memory soon. So I'll adjust the cards and then we will pull the center energy, okay? All right, see you in a moment. All right, here we go, part 2. So this is going to be the twin flame... twin flame part of the reading. So this will represent the union energies. I just wanted to look at the bottom of this deck here, the Call It Bear and Read. So I'm just going to give it a quick shuffle and then look at the bottom of the deck, and that will represent the overall energy. And I will pull 2 final cards for that. So 1 for the feminine, 1 for the masculine. Okay. The 8 of Pentacles. So take great pride in your excellent work. Practice makes perfect. Consider getting additional education or training. So this talks about putting a lot of work and effort into something and finally seeing the fruits of your labor. So the feminine got that in her fear position. So she fears that she won't have that happy ending, the 10 of Pentacles, but the masculine is clearly thinking about that in his, how he views a relationship. So this is, as an overall energy, you've both been doing a lot of work. You're being recognized for all that work that you've put in to the relationship, and that harvest is near, and that's definitely what I'm getting from this reading. Okay. So, 2 cards. 6 of Wands, triumph, victory, success. It's having that payoff, harvest, abundance, being recognized, being illuminated, being the example. People are proud of you. It's public recognition. So that's the energy that the feminines bring in for the masculine. 7 of Cups, not surprised. This is kind of reflects this energy here of feeling like things are an illusion, they're not real, but then having a vision of your future, which requires a tower to come down. It has to do with communication. So his energy is the Seven of Cups. This talks about not knowing if something's real, if it's all an illusion. It's also about having too many choices ahead of you. So trying to make a decision. So, yeah, a choice. And that's why that moon is showing up in the resisting position for the feminine, because, you know, there's a sense of haze. It's not seeing things clearly. Okay, so moving into the union energy. So John Holland, solar plexus chakra, finding strength, just jumped out. Okay, so the first card is going to be for the feminine. This is what she's bringing into the union. Nice! Okay, so this is a John Holland deck. So this is my calling card, 1111 connection. The Four of Wands. We don't have the 1111 card for the John Holland, so this is my calling card that I use for this deck. So you are bringing in the 1111 connection. Bam. So you got that in your present position. This cycle of change, this foundation, this happy ending. So you're bringing that energy straight into the union. All right, so what is the masculine bringing into the union? Spiritual strength. So he got the ten of wands. So did you. And you got the nine of wands in the energy that's surrounding. So he's getting this as bringing into the union. So he has been doing a lot of work on his spiritual growth. He's finding strength and courage within him for that one final push to victory. Okay, so for the foundation, this is union energy. Nice. The Fool card, new beginning, stepping out into the unknown, not fearing the journey, brand new beginning, making a decision to move forward and taking that step. Leaving your old life behind, beginning all over again, but being excited about the adventure, stepping out into the unknown as a child, innocent, free, no expectations, just going for it. So that's a union energy as the foundation. Okay, the crowning energy, nice, crown chakra. Oh my God, awareness, illumination, awakening. Shared energy. You're both tapped into the ethereal collective. And this is a crowning energy. You got the crown chakra. Whoa. Okay, heart-centered energy. Balance. 11. Finding that ultimate balance between the physical and the spiritual. It is, this is a justice card. This is karma coming back to you. What you reap, you sow. So karma is coming back in a good way, and it's ultimate balance. And I love that it's 11. So it's the balance of the yin and the yang. The being open to receive and giving. It's just ultimate balance. That's awesome. Wow. All right. So now I'm going to pull one card from the Osho deck as clarifiers for each of these cards. Okay, so for the Four of Wands, please, what is your additional message for the Four of Wands? The energy that the feminine is bringing into the union. What is this Four of Wands? Additional message. Nice. The Queen of Cups. Receptivity. And that's exactly what I'm seeing in the reading. You are standing here open, receptive. You are impregnated with this seed and you're nurturing and growing it. So I will be reading from this card. So that coupled with the Four of Wands, you know it's a twin flame connection. You got this in your present position. It is almost exactly a mirror of these two cards. So we got the Queen of Cups, be emotionally stable, knowing the truth, seeing the overall picture of this union, being impregnated with the seed in the 3D world and that 11-11 connection. So then you're bringing that into the union, the 11-11 connection and the Queen of Cups. Wow, what a powerful combination. Okay, for the masculine, set Five of Wands again. That's the third time he's got this. So he got it in his message from his higher self, and as an outcome. So Five of Wands, maybe it'll give us more clarity, but this card talks about being in the now and trusting. It is letting go and believing that someone is going to be on the other side to catch you. So there's that, you know, he's stepping into a spiritual knowing and overcoming that obstacle and trusting and letting go. Okay, so for the grounding energy, I'm going to pull two cards. The first is the feminine. Nine of Cups. This is wish granted. Wish is fulfilled. It's feeling emotionally satisfied and abundant. And it also talks about not needing to do anything. It's a state of not doing. So that coupled with the Fool card, it's almost like you're sitting here waiting to take that step. You're confident about your future. But this card also comes with a warning as well. You know, not acting on something will cause your dreams or that sense of security to collapse. You know, we got this broken mirror here. Okay, one more card for that. Nine of Swords. The masculine got this in his recent past position. So being trapped in the mind, staying up at night, and being exhausted, worrying, trapped in fear, unable to take that step because you feel imprisoned by your mind. So you got two nines here. That means that it's nearing the completion. Two nines with a zero in the middle. Crazy. So if you know, I would highly recommend that you guys check out vortex-based mathematics. It explains what numbers mean. Numbers are like coordinates. They are fixed states that cannot be unchained. It is the matrix of the material world. Okay, so zero is source. It is the birth, the creation of energy. It's what Tesla uses. He taps into zero point energy and draws power from the universe. Nine is the soul. Nine is, we'll leave a link in the description box below, but nine is the soul. It is the ultimate powerful number. It is the building block or the link to the matrix. It is what shapes all numbers. So you both got the nine. So it's like you're both in here, showing yourself in the rawest form. So here he's trapped by fear, but nearing that completion, ready to step forward. Whereas the feminine is feeling emotionally satisfied, but kind of in a way taking this new beginning for granted, or I don't know, but I would like to focus on the positive aspect of this. This is wish granted, emotionally satisfied. Okay, so for the crowning energy, two cards starting with the feminine. Nice. Eight of Wands again. He got this in his present position, and he also got it in what he, oh, in his how he views love and relationships. So, communication, the feminine. It's like she is tapped into the collective. Woo. She realizes that the destination is the journey. It's not a place of attainment. It's not something out there that you need to reach. It is realizing that every step that you take right now in this moment is the destination. But again, Eight of Wands is about communication. So, there's almost like this sense of that cord, that ethereal connection with your twin. You have your crown chakra open and receiving light and communication. For the masculine, the King of Swords again. So, where did this card show up? King of Swords. Oh, here we go. So it was that surrounding energy that the feminine had in her on her side. So it has to do with the Five of Swords. So releasing attachment to something. It's truth, communication, straight up. It is clarity of thought. It is speaking your truth. It is using strong mental control. So this is I know. This crown chakra is I know. And this is clarity of thought, speaking truth. And this is communication. So it's almost like, look at that beam of light coming from the crown chakra over here. It is, acting on your idea and knowing that truth. I know. Clarity of thought. Okay, so the heart-centered energy, feminine first. Nice! The master. Oh my God. Oh my God, awesome. That you've arrived. You, this, wow. I will read this card to you. The master. You are the Zen master. And yes, that's what your reading is reflecting. It's this energy. It's knowing. It's completion. It's being open. It's finality. Knowing your power and holding it. And for the masculine, Thunderbolt, the Tower card. That's what he got right here for his how he views his the relationship, the Tower coming down, letting go of fear. So the Tower shows up when something major is about to happen. It completely destroys your foundation. Everything you ever attached yourself to will come falling down because it was built on falsehood, false beliefs, false attachments, So this energy will come in very quickly and suddenly, and it will crash down, bringing everything with it. So there's a figure behind the tower. It is consciousness. It's being the observer. It's allowing that tower to fall, finally. Stripping away the old. So it's like, you know, you are providing this balance here. It's almost like opposite energies here. There's this sudden strike. And then we have the master here. You're providing this grounded energy, this knowing, this consciousness. And he's starting to realize his consciousness. He's the observer. He's becoming the observer. So there's a balance here. You know, there's this negative energy or something, you know, drastic is about to occur. But you are providing that grounded energy, and that's exactly what the reading is showing. It's fire. It's a fireball. Okay, and he got almost all of his cards here are wand energy. See all the orange? Sorry, I'll have to adjust the camera. So I'll show it from my view once we're done the reading. But there's this fireball of energy and ignition and a thrust forward. And then you, the feminines, not you, but the feminine, are providing this pentacle. All the pink is a grounded energy. It's a knowing. So there's a beautiful balance here between the two. There's fire and then grounding. And again, there's, you know, up here, there's that grounded energy. There's not knowing success, which is fire. But there's that balance between the two. I just absolutely love seeing this. Wow. Okay, so let's pull message from the universe, one each. Then I'm going to stop the video, have a look at the cards. I will look over those messages from the Osho, see if there's, you know, deeper meaning, and then I may read a couple of them. I don't think I'm going to read all of them to you. That'll just take too long. Okay, so for the feminine, please, what is your message from the universe? Details, details in reverse. And for the masculine, okay, strength. So these are both in reverse, so I'm going to turn them upright. So strength, finding your strength to move forward with something, standing in your spiritual knowing, not being knocked off course. So he's finding spiritual strength to accomplish everything he desires. We got a 43 and 44, which is a progression. 43, this is about making those small gestures. It's the small things that count. Okay, so let me just stop it there, and I will have a look. I will go through the reading for you guys and then read a couple of cards for you. All right, cheers. See you in a minute. All right, beautiful souls, here is your reading. Okay, so to run through the cards really quickly, I just wanted to show this overall, look at all the orange here, fire. It's this birth, this realization, this thrust forward. It's like a coming into your power and going forward with your vision. And then over here on the feminine side, look at all the pink. That's pentacles. That's grounding energy. You're standing here in a peaceful state. Awake, aware. And you're standing in your truth. You know, as the divine feminine. but even more so as the master. You're the master Zen. You have completed this major cycle, and you are being recognized for all of the work. You are so balanced and in tune with your inner knowing. Okay, so Seven of Swords. He sees his future. He wants to communicate. He feels that he can't, like he did something in the past that is unforgivable. And in order to achieve this Ten of Pentacles, a tower needs to come down. What he's resisting. He's resisting this 11-11 connection. But he knows the feminine is the object of his desire, and he wants to be with her in the 3D. And this is causing a great deal of stress. Message from his higher self. He is finding his power to overcome these obstacles. He's finding balance, which is coming in the center of the reading here. So he is finding his strength, and it's because of that love, two cups connection. The nine, he is seeing things from a different perspective, stepping into his power, releasing himself from that mental prison and seeing a bright future, taking the blindfold off. Present position. He's in a hermit state, but he is, again, trying to find that balance and plan for the future. And there's that sense of communication, thrust forward. Good news. As an outcome, that final completion, the end of that long, arduous journey and cutting away the negativity. Message from the universe, good news. The gasoline has been poured on the fire. There's this sense of the ship coming in, that final reward, no longer feeling left out. The energy surrounding him, somebody from the past that he thinks about in a loving way is giving him strength to communicate and to step into his power. And this could mean a reunion of some kind. But he's afraid to communicate his love. He's afraid to embrace his emotions. But there's a sense that he's healing his broken heart. On the feminine side, you are so awake, it's crazy. You are in touch with your emotions. You know this, the truth of this connection. But there's a sense that there's a sense of conflict, or not conflict, sorry, there's a sense that you don't really know your way clearly, or see, that's in your resisting position, right? So you're resisting speaking your truth, possibly. Because there's a state of just not knowing your way clearly. Message from the higher self. Ace of Cups, this is true love. Your wait is almost over with the Seven of Pentacles, and justice is on your side. It's an end to feeling exhausted. It's a new love, or like it's a brand new beginning in love. It's coming. And again, that the justice card is repeated. It's a shared energy for the union. So have patience, hold your grounded energy and love, and have patience. Yeah. Okay, so recent past, the Ace of Wands is that go light. It's like that aha moment. It's that creative spark. It's you provided that spark that set him ablaze. So it has to do with communicating your truth, and you went through some type of metamorphosis and you emerged as the High Priestess. Presently, you are recognized for all of the hard work that you've done, and reward is coming. And the High Priest is right beside you. We've got the High Priestess and High Priest. The winds of change are occurring, and karma is coming back to you. You've got this Four of Wands here. It's that harvest, that completion. And here in your, as an outcome, we've got this 3D manifestation of the King of Pentacles with the Magician. It's like it's something in the future is going to be materialized. And he's riding the chariot. Again, that repeated theme of being on fire, being in your power, and moving forward. Going after what you desire. So he will arrive as this king in the 3D world. Something will be manifested. An opening. An arrival. Message from your higher self, again with that Five of Swords. He got it. I can't remember. But it's that recurring theme. It's that sense of, you know, pointing fingers. And that's kind of what's stalling him. The feeling like, you know, he did something wrong in the past and that he can't move forward because it's causing a stall. But ultimately, he is working on stepping into his divinity and that Ace of Cups, that new beginning. The energy surrounding is very chaotic. It's a wounded warrior. There's that Five of Swords again, sorry. But we got that King of Air there. That's communication. It's finally speaking your truth and stepping into clarity, which is that crowning energy. Okay, so what you fear is not having that Ten of Pentacles, that finality, that final resting place, and you're longing for it. You want that opening. You want the fruits of your labor. So moving into the center here. So there is a connection through the crown chakra. There you are holding the light, holding the truth, which is giving him the strength to move through this tower, to trust, to believe in his spiritual journey. And ultimately, there will be that release, that completion, and that step forward. So, like I was saying, the feminine, bringing this beautiful, grounded energy. You know what you want, and you believe in this twin flame connection. So I'm going to read receptivity to you. The masculine side, finding spiritual strength to push, to take that last step, that you know, overcome that obstacle. And like I said, trust. So I'm going to read that trust to you. Then the union energy, the feminine got the master. Again, holding that knowing, which will allow him to go through that process, allow that tower to come down, which ultimately will awaken him. He will step into that same conscious energy, and you will arrive together as the master, Zen. Okay, so let me read those to you. I'm just going to pause it.
I'm going to start with the feminine energy here. She brought in the Four of Wands and the Queen of Cups, receptivity. So receptivity represents the feminine, receptive quality of water and of the emotions. Her arms are extended upward to receive, and she is completely immersed in water. She has no head, no busy and aggressive mind to hinder her pure receptivity. And as she is filled, she is continuously emptying herself, overflowing and receiving more. The lotus pattern or matrix that emerges from her represents the perfect harmony of the universe that becomes apparent when we are in tune with it. The Queen of Water brings a time of unboundless and gratitude for whatever life brings, without any expectations or demands. Neither duty or thought of merit or reward are important. Sensitivity, intuition, and compassion are the qualities that shine forth now, dissolving all obstacles that keep us separate from each other and from the whole. Okay, and then I'm going to read his card here. He got spiritual strength with totality. Sorry. Okay, totality. Every moment there is possibility to be total. Whatsoever you are doing, be absorbed in it so utterly that the mind thinks nothing, is just there, is just present, and more totality will be coming. And the taste of totality will make you more and more capable of being total. And try to see when you are not total. Those are the moments which have to be dropped slowly, slowly. When you are not total, whenever you are in the head, thinking, brooding, calculating, cunning, clever, you are not total. Slowly, slowly slip out of those moments. It's just an old habit. Habits die hard, but they die certainly. If one persists, they die. So there's that sense of, you know, the king stepping into this clarity of thought and just being in the moment, which again is reflected in the Thunderbolt card. So the shared union energy is balance, and the feminine got the master. So I'm going to read that. Okay. Masters don't teach the truth. There is no way to teach it. It is a transmission beyond scriptures, beyond words. It's a transmission. It is energy provoking energy in you. It is a kind of synchronicity. You have to approach the master with great love, with great trust, with an open heart. You're not aware who you are. He is aware who he is. He is aware who you are. The caterpillar might be said to be unaware that it may become a butterfly. You are caterpillars, a buddhistas. All caterpillars are buddhistas. And all buddhistas are caterpillars. A buddhista means when one who can become a butterfly, who can become a Buddha, who can become a Buddha in the seed. In the essence, the master discipline relationship is the relationship between a caterpillar and a butterfly, a friendship between a caterpillar and a butterfly. The butterfly cannot prove that the caterpillar can become a butterfly. There is no logical way, but the butterfly can provoke a longing in the caterpillar. That is possible. Okay, so Thunderbolt. The card shows a tower being burned, destroyed, blown apart. A man and a woman are leaping from it, not because they want to, but because they have no choice. In the background is a transparent, meditating figure representing the witnessing conscious. You might be feeling pretty shaky right now, as if the earth is rocking beneath your feet. Your sense of security is being challenged, and the natural tendency is to try to hold on to whatever you can. But this is inner earthquake. Is both necessary and tremendously important, if you allow it. You will emerge from the wreckage stronger and more available for new experiences. After the fire, the earth is replenished. After the storm, the air is clear. Try to watch the destruction with detachment, almost as if it were happening to somebody else. Say yes to the process by meeting it halfway. So halfway, that balance, coming into consciousness, awareness. So number 44, strength. So this is a message from the universe to the masculine. Your true strength comes not from self-reliance alone, but from sincere faith in a higher power. The strength to accomplish even the most daunting tasks is yours at this time. So again, spiritual strength. You can connect with and channel the power of the universe. The strength card indicates that your ideas are being tested and refined, and your relationships are being deepened. No matter what happens, nothing can move you off course of evolution. As the potency of your connection becomes more obvious, you are able to harness the creative energies that are available to you. Have courage and dive in, for magic is in process of finding form. When you remember that real strength comes from a combination of your efforts and reliance on the higher power working through you, all is possible. You can do anything right now. Number 43, details is what the feminine got. The most powerful patterns are created within the tiniest details. Pay attention. This is a time to be aware of the fine print in all areas of life. Look at the details and leave the broader strokes for another time. When this card appears in a reading, it's a sign to finesse a project. Make small but meaningful gestures or add personal touch to your correspondence. Be aware that what you need to know lies in the details. If you're entering into an agreement of any kind, pay attention to them before, not after, when it's too late. Clarity and transparency are key. You can gain great understanding by observing the minute body languages, offhand remarks, and fleeting facial expressions that reveal the larger picture. So, yeah, I'm getting this sense that Spirit is asking you to be conscious, be aware, but make small and meaningful gestures towards your masculine. Don't force your will. Be the observer. Be the Zen master. And hold that grounded energy. All right, I hope this helped you guys. Much love to you. Cheers.